501 Harrison Street, Oakland. Admission $15 advance, $20 at the door. Tickets at independent bookstores or by calling 510-832-9000, extension 305. Benefits Media Alliance, co-sponsored by KPFA, Global Exchange, San Francisco Bay Guardian, and Cody's Books. Reception at 7 p.m. with Amy Goodman. $75 includes reserved seating. For more information, contact www.media-alliance.org or call 510-832-9000, extension 305.
Listening to KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, or KFCF in Fresno. Or on the web, you can listen at kpfa.org. It's 7 p.m., and up next is Full Circle, so stay with us.
You're traveling through another dimension.
An area not only of sound and ideas, but light.
You're taking a journey to a land without boundaries, where diversity rules.
A dimension that is both multicultural and intergenerational.
You are moving into a field of empowerment and expression.
You are crossing into Full Circle.
Welcome to Full Circle, your cultural and public affairs radio magazine. Last Friday, we talked about time and culture, and tonight on Full Circle,
we have an open house with various community organizations from the Bay Area.
And we are also in our spring fun drive. Later in the program, you'll hear music from the Eye of the Storm CD.
We are your hosts, William and Idris. Stay tuned. Tonight, we are joined by a host of representatives from various community organizations. They're going to tell us a bit about their groups and their mission. This will be a sharing experience where we learn how KPFM Full Circle as media can better serve our communities.
We have 9 organizations here tonight. We're going to ask you all a few questions. First, introduce yourself and tell us about the community your organization serves, and please describe some of the issues your community faces and what you are doing to address them. Let's start with Shamara Castro of Art and Action Youth Leadership.
Hi, thank you so much for having us on air. Art in Action is a youth leadership program. We're based in Oakland, California, and we serve youth ages 16 to 25. Our main program is in the summer, and it is a 10-day youth leadership training camp that focuses on 3 different areas, those being training on social justice, arts activism, and community and self-empowerment. The majority of the youth who come to our training are youth of color, youth who identify as queer, working class, homeless, and women as well. And our main program in the summer, our main goal is to organize a performance, a multidisciplinary performance that we perform to the community that we're in. And our tracks within the youth leadership training program as well are hip-hop, movement, dance, spoken word. We do a lot of visual arts as well, music. And this year we're including digital storytelling as one of our programs.
Also joining us this evening, Joseph Smook of Bernal Heights Neighborhood Center in San Francisco, a group that's been around for about 26 or some odd years. Tell us a bit about what you're doing over there.
That's right. And, over the years, we've developed quite a community center in Bernal Heights. And we serve not just the Bernal Heights community in San Francisco, which is kind of on the south end of the Mission, which is a little bit better known to people outside of San Francisco. But we also serve the Excelsior and the Outer Mission parts of San Francisco because of the diversity and the need and the lack of services in that part of San Francisco. So, like I said, we're truly a community center. We're a place where the community comes together around a number of different issues. But our mission, the mission of the Neighborhood Center is really all about preserving and enhancing diversity and providing services for those most in need and building leadership and power in our community. So how we do that is through a membership base. We're truly rooted in the community. So our agency is actually run by a board of directors. It's elected through our membership, and that membership is made up of primarily people who live and work in Bernal Heights, and all of our clients wherever we serve. And we do serve not just in Bernal Heights, as I was saying, but we develop affordable housing. We have over 200 units of affordable housing, and they're kind of all over the city of San Francisco because it's such a huge need. And we serve through our housing very low-income seniors and families, homeless individuals and families, people with special needs. We also have services for seniors in our community, both active and frail seniors. We have a tremendous array of volunteers who participate with our staff to provide services to the homebound seniors and people who can make it to the senior center for activities, case management, food, and basic necessities. Our youth services are equally broad. Serving again both the Bernal and Excelsior Outer Mission neighborhoods, and we have job training programs, we have case management and recreational activities, and we work through networks. Actually, all of our services work through networks throughout San Francisco. We do economic development, we do land use planning, and we also do community organizing, and that's really for us where it all comes back to, is really cultivating issues, educating around social justice analysis, doing social action, and because the forces that fight diversity, which is what we're all about, are so powerful that we feel it's our job to counter those forces with the power that we build through coming together as a community.
Thanks, Joseph. Berlina Galette joins us here on Full Circle tonight. We are doing a community open house, and we're asking each of our panelists, tell us about your community and which community your organization serves, and also describe some of the issues your communities are facing and what you're doing to address them. Berlina Galette of CASA, tell us about CASA and what it stands for.
Well, CASA stands for Court-Appointed Special Advocate. What we do is we train volunteers to advocate for children in foster care. We serve Alameda County. Our focus is strictly children in foster care. We train our volunteers to be advocates around their permanency, making sure that their environment is safe, whatever their social psychological needs are. We have educational advocacy that we do, whereas we train volunteers to simply work on the educational issues of our foster youth. Many of our foster youth are failing. They're dropping out. They're not graduating. They're finding it hard to find jobs. They basically are going from the schoolyard to the jail yard. Mm-hmm. And our purpose and our focus is to stop that. We serve approximately 150 to 200 children, which is such a small percentage given that there are over 5,000 kids in foster care in Alameda County. So our focus and our goal is to expand our volunteer base. Our volunteer training is approximately 30-plus hours. Once you complete our training, you're sworn in as an officer of the court. And what that does is that gives you the right to work with other collaborative parties, sort of like the public defender, the prosecutors, anyone who has a role in that child's life. You're working with those parties to improve the conditions in which that child is living while in foster care. We also are focused on trying to find permanency for these children, trying to identify places that or relatives that will take them on and become their legal guardian or adopt them, anything that's going to give them permanency within their life. It's very hard to grow up in foster care. It's very hard to get education when you're being moved from place to place. And so CASA's role is to provide stability and permanency in a child's life.
Celine Shine of the Chundum Dance Company, please share with us about your organization.
Yes, thank you. I'm the executive director of the Chitresh Das Dance Company and Chundum School of Kathak. And our mission is to produce exemplary traditional, innovative, and collaborative works of North Indian classical Kathak dance, to increase the awareness of Kathak dance, and to train future generations and build local, national, and international community support for the Kathak tradition. And our focus is really both local and grassroots, as well as international. We have what is actually the largest Indian classical dance school in North America. Here in the Bay Area, we have 5 locations in San Francisco, Berkeley, Mountain View, Union City, and San Jose, with 15 teachers and 35 classes per week. And simultaneously, we have a sister school in India. So our goal is to really increase awareness about Kathak and traditional arts on a larger scale, as well as to build a bridge with the mother country of this culture and art, India. And some of the challenges that we face are just general awareness and support for the arts. A real focus of our artistic director and the founder of the organization, Chitresh Das, is not just to teach the dance, but it's really crucial to learn the culture, philosophy, and history behind the art. So that requires incredible amount of commitment and time and energy, and to get students and the community to support that is quite a challenge for us, but something that we welcome and truly enjoy. We have quite a few programs. There's the Chitresh Das Dance Company, and this company performs locally, nationally, and tours annually in India. We have our youth dance company, which has been a really rewarding program, both for the organization as well as for the community, giving children access to training in this classical art as it is traditional to start from a young age. So we're really happy and thrilled with that program, which started in 2002. We also have an arts education program, which reaches 6,000 to 8,000 children annually, which we're very happy about. And we're producing a international Kathak festival and symposium in September. One of the larger challenges that we face is that the tradition of Kathak is actually a solo art form. And that art form is actually in decline rapidly in India and internationally. It's being replaced by large glitzy productions, fusion work. And so we're really on a mission, to make sure that this tradition is preserved for future generations. And really the issues that are surrounding the decline of this tradition are shared by many traditional forms. One cannot underestimate the impact of Western economic power and media on these traditions. So we're really hoping through this international festival and symposium to create awareness about the loss or potential loss of these traditions and what we can do to preserve them.
We're joined here tonight by 9 community organizations who are sharing with us some of the work that they do in the community. Rachel Mays of Critical Resistance, please talk to us about your work.
Yes, well, Critical Resistance is a national grassroots organization with 10 chapters. I'm here representing the Oakland chapter. The Critical Resistance belief, we kind of seek to build an international movement to end the prison industrial complex. By challenging the belief that caging and controlling people makes us safer. We believe that the basic necessities such as food, shelter, and jobs, and freedom are what really keeps us safe in a community. Work such as global struggles against inequality and powerlessness, and believe that the success of the movement requires that it reflect the communities most affected by the PIC. We have several work groups that we do. One of them is Critical Resistance Radio, which airs here on KBFA on the fourth Friday of every month. We also have another work group called Operation Impact, which is challenging the actual Operation Impact that is enforced by the Oakland police, which is basically an excuse for racial profiling. The Oakland police, as well as the sheriff and the highway patrol, work in conjunction and go through poorer neighborhoods in the community, mainly the Fruitvale area, and are allowed to pull people over, based on their racial profiling. We do work with writing letters to prisoners as well, and basically want to keep the community involved and not forget about those people who are behind bars and realize that a large majority of people in Oakland are affected by the PIC. Either they have been incarcerated or their families are incarcerated, or they are unable to find employment after their incarceration. So that's kind of what Critical Resistance says.
Thank you very much, Rachel. And we are also joined by Ying Liu of the East Bay Sanctuary Covenant. Why don't you tell us a bit about your group?
Hi. Yes. Our group is East Bay Sanctuary Covenant, a nonprofit organization located in Berkeley, California. It was originally formed in 1982 by a group of five multi-denominational congregations that were offering sanctuary to Central American refugees, that is, victims of the civil wars in Guatemala and El Salvador. And today we continue to offer free and low-cost legal services to immigrants, not only from Central America, but we've expanded to help also immigrants from all over the world, especially asylum seekers. We've had clients come in from Africa, from Central Asia, from anywhere around the world where people are fleeing persecution and war and discrimination. So our main areas that we work on are, one, affirmative asylum, and a second area is temporary protective status. And my personal program that I'm working on is NACARA, which offers legal residency directly to refugees from the civil wars from Central America. And also, we help asylum seekers who are being held in INS detention centers. So we are one of the few walk-in facilities where people can just walk in and drop by to get help. At times, they have to wait a bit, and because we are a nonprofit organization, but we try our best to help everyone we can. And in addition to our legal services, we also help our clients find food, shelter, medical care, and jobs, because many people come here with very little. And we do have a separate department that helps the community kind of help itself as well.
Thank you very much, Ying. Okay. You're listening to Full Circle. We are inside our Fungi, but we're also having a community open house where we've invited a number of different community organizations in to talk a bit about how we as media can become more accountable. And we're going to talk with Fred Jackson, who's with the Neighborhood House of North Oakland. I'm sorry, North Richmond. Neighborhood House of North Richmond. Welcome, Fred.
Thank you. Thank you very much. The Neighborhood House of North Richmond is a community-based social service agency that was founded in 1954. In fact, it was founded by the Quakers, in fact. And it started out as a small agency, but it has since evolved into a multi-purpose agency with many programs. One of my programs is residential substance abuse treatment. And we have an outpatient substance abuse treatment as well. We have a community career resource center. We also have the Internet Project for Street Peace, which is a computer-based violence prevention program, which was conceived by the late Stanley Tucker Williams, who was executed in December. We also have a multicultural family service center to address issues and needs of our seniors. We also have HIV and AIDS community outreach prevention. We also have a newly established program, the West County Transportation Center, which now resides at the Neighborhood House in North Richmond. And I point out the Neighborhood House, we 2 years ago, we purchased the old East Bay Hospital, and that's where a lot of our program currently resides. But also we have programs that also resides in North Richmond. And those who know Richmond, especially North Richmond, high in the crime and so forth. And so most people know the basic needs of improvised community. And we also work with the environmental people. Project RIA, which is Richmond Effort and Abatement of Lead, we also collaborate with the city of Richmond in cleaning lead from houses constructed prior to 1978. And we also have case managers who work with families that are referred to Families and Children's Services, case-by-case management. And so we have a wide range of programs, and we are constantly in community development as we move forward and to do even greater work. Thank you.
All right, so why don't we take a break right here? You are listening to Full Circle. This is the community open house. We are inside with nine different organizations from throughout the Bay Area who've come in to talk a bit about their programs, and we're going to go to break and be back right after this.
Yamile. Yamile. Odo. Bobo ache. Ise misara mawoe. Yamile.
Mother Water, we are created from deep within your dark indigo. Life flowed to the land in the wave of your hand, and now we ask your blessing, your mercy, and protection. Above all, for those who have met their watery end, held tightly in your bosom, delivered to spirit in your tsunamis, hurricanes, fierce winds, and all manifestations of your natural power to destroy. Instead, we ask for your bounty, your beauty, your love. Mother Ocean, Sister River, from you we come. To you we shall return. Above all, we ask for your blessing. Ye Maya and Oshun, we ask for your love. Yamile.
Music from Carolyn Brandy and Ohala featuring Eloise Burrell. The name of the song is Iyami Ile, Prayer to Mother Water, and this is a song from the CD Eye of the Storm, Love and Rage from the Bay to the Gulf, which is a brand new CD recording to benefit survivors of Hurricane Katrina.
You can get this CD as a thank you gift when you pledge for Full Circle during this fund drive. We'll be playing more tracks later on in the show. You are listening to KPFA 94.1 FM. This is Full Circle. We are your hosts, Idris and William.
And tonight we're having a conversation with various community organizations from throughout the Bay Area.
And next we'll be joined with Elise Gang of Women of Color Resource Center.
Where the Women of Color Resource Center was established in 1990. Currently, we reside in downtown Oakland, and we work to provide education and resources to women of color and women of color organizers in the United States. We focus our work around issues of militarism, globalization, and also welfare. We currently have a project in which we are developing an anti-militarism popular education curriculum for organizers to be able to guide or teach on issues of militarism. And we are also studying policies. We are also studying how welfare policies are affecting women of color today. We have the Welfare Radio Collaborative, which is a project in which we train women who have been personally affected by the welfare system, and we provide them with political education as well as technical training in radio production. And so they produce short radio pieces or extended radio documentaries on issues that affect women of color today.
And Elle's...
Elisa
Kuya?
No, that's me.
Oh,
that's okay.
That's Elle's Kuya.
Elle's Kuya. What's up?
From You Speaks.
Hi.
Hello. How are you?
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Elisa, and Now we welcome Alice. You're from Youth Speaks. Tell us a bit about your group.
I am. I'm very lucky to be working for my favorite nonprofit organization on the planet. It's called Youth Speaks. It's a very special year for us because it's our 10th year. 2006 rings in our 10th year. It's very exciting. The communities that we serve are youth ages 13 to 24. And because these kids come from all walks of life, really the challenges that we face as an organization are the same challenges that many of you, many of the other organizations who spoke earlier face, and that is the media, the prison industrial complex, poverty, not having enough things to do in the neighborhoods. And the way that we're combating that is we're in the schools, we're giving kids an opportunity to develop their voice, to find their voice, to develop and publicly present their voice through open mics, through the national and international youth poetry slam, through workshops. And we're really giving these kids an opportunity to develop themselves as leaders. Just to share with you what our vision is, it's very strong and it's very exciting. Our vision is to shift perceptions of youth by combating illiteracy, alienation, and silence to create a global movement of brave new voices, bringing the noise from the margins to the core. That's dope. And that's what Youth Speaks is about.
Deep.
Wow. Wow, thank you very much for sharing that with us. Again, tonight we are joined by 9 community organizations from different parts of the Bay Area. And as journalists, we would like to ask the question, how can media serve you and your community? Let's start off with Shamara.
Well, I think that for the Young People of Art in Action and the organization itself, there's a lot of ways that media can really help us. One of them, I think, is to continue to highlight some of the issues that we've already talked about here with all the different organizations, which are the issues that our young people are facing, whether it's the prison industrial complex, homelessness, not having a lot of resources in the community, maybe, you know, being recruited by the military, is them seeing that as one of the only options for them. So definitely continuing to highlight those issues and put that in the forefront of people's minds and exposing that. But another way as well is to, I think, highlight youth stories for us, because one of the things that is really powerful within our organization is to hear young people's stories, hear where they're coming from, and when they gain the tools and the skills to be able to tell those stories, they need an outlet for that. And media is a perfect opportunity, whether it's radio, whether it's TV or film or video or any aspect of media, really needed as a tool to get these youth's voices out.
Sheila Mata Castro of the Art and Action Leadership Group. Is that right?
Yeah.
I got
that's right.
You
got it.
All right. Speaking of prison industrial complex and media, let's talk with Rachel Mays, who also works with Critical Resistance. And like you said, Critical Resistance is a part of the KPFA family, hosting a program every fourth Friday?
Yes, every fourth Friday on Hard Knock Radio.
Okay. Tell us a bit, how can we be more accountable, and what are some of the ways that you're using media as working with Critical Resistance in the show that you produce here?
Well, one of the ways we use it is again, on the radio show Critical Resistance. I guess one way is that I think that many prisoners are looked at or forgotten about. They're a forgotten part of society. And I'm not really sure how the media could help that at all, except being a convict, you know, or being incarcerated has certain connotations, and I think that the media portrays prisoners and people who have been in trouble with the law in a certain light, which I think that would help if we as a community could look at things differently and look at people as having a second chance and see redemption, you know, as a good thing and as a possible thing. I think that if prisoners' rights were highlighted more in the media as a whole, you know, maybe on the news, things like that, that could help a lot. I know that people look at prisoners as a separate part of society or not even a part of society. So again, shedding a better light on that would be one way of doing that.
Okay, thank you. So it's interesting that we do talk about how prisoners are forgotten. Another context that another group that often is forgotten is younger folks. And I know that with the Bernal Heights Neighborhood Center is a group that's working to prevent that. Joseph Smith, Bernal Heights.
So one of the things that's really paramount for us, in addition to working with the youth and giving the youth a voice, which heard comments on that, it's incredibly important. Having access to media is important, but getting the message out that how people choose to spend their money, basically how you use your dollars speaks. When you're barraged by the media, when you're barraged by the kind of mainstream commercial media, that you're told basically that you become legitimate. You become a legitimate person by how you spend your money. It's basically that you're legitimizing your existence by spending your money on Coca-Cola and buying cars and all the kind of mainstream culture that's being force-fed to people as through your development years. That's where you're really kind of transformed as a person, and as you're force fed all this all the kind of crap of how you're supposed to legitimize your existence, you grow up with that. And what we try to do is redirect that, and media can certainly help by sending out the message of every time you spend your money, you're making a choice of how you want your community to be, how you want yourself to be, and that there is a more constructive way to participate in society, and that is by not believing the hype that's out there and really engaging in the issues that are meaningful. And that's a matter of understanding and educating yourself about what's meaningful in the community, and not just thinking about, all right, well, how am I going to look cool tomorrow? So that's a really powerful role that media can play is to divert from mainstream and give access to that kind of analysis of how you exist in your society.
Thank you very much, Joseph. Mr. Fred Jackson, can you share with us how the media can serve your community with Neighborhood House of North Richmond? So can you talk to us about that?
Yes, thank you. North Richmond, an enclave of like 3,500 people, and at one time within 3 years, there were 6 to 8 homicides just in that small population. And usually, unfortunately, when the kids see media, it's usually coming to report on a homicide or something that has occurred in a violent way. And so therefore kids figure they have to act out. It's before I can rate to be on TV or radio, I gotta do something out of the ordinary. And so what I would like to see media do is find a niche. When I said find a niche, I mean find a niche to deal with the unsung heroes, where we can take kids and say, you can be on KPFA. You can be on Channel 4 without acting out. So just by the fact that you're going to school, just by the fact that you have aspirations of being somebody, you are somebody for us. You are a hero. And bring them on and let them talk to the world and say, I'm trying. And that will put some self-esteem into them. I've tried this and it works. And kids will, you'll be surprised what kids will do.
Let's talk about what kids can do, and because that's very true, Fred. Els Kuya, who works with Youth Speaks, you work with young people who've been on our air here at KPFA. So tell us how we can be more accountable to young people, not just in North Richmond, but throughout the Bay Area.
Definitely. So, excuse me. Our youth are learning to be more media literate by the day, because we talk about how they relate to the things that they see on MTV, to the things that they listen to on the radio, how they deal with the things that they that are pushed upon them in magazines and on billboards all the time. As a matter of fact, we start our new series of winter workshops on Monday, and one of those workshops deal with media literacy. So there's going to be one unit on magazines and one unit on hip-hop and one unit on how the news is framed. So kids can really get a grip on what it means and how they should respond to that, or what they really feel about that, or rather than it just being placed upon them, which I think is really, really empowering for the kids, and to be able to think critically about what they see and to have something to say about it. So I'm really excited about that, and I would invite anyone who knows kids, have kids, or like kids to please bring them out to Youth Speaks and check out the workshops that we have to offer, because the kids really do have something to say about the media. And then also to answer your earlier question about how the media can serve us is, like, we're really challenged to have media come in and take a look at what we do as far as our educational programs. Like, they're all about the slams, and they really like to see kids on stage and the audience screaming and cheering. But what we also do in schools is huge, and is a huge story, which the media, it's not like the hot thing. The hot thing is the kids on stage, but it's also important to share that story as well and to express the need for these kinds of programs in schools. So I would love to see that happen more.
Berlina Goulet, working with CASA and young people in the adoption and foster care system, can you address the question of how the media can better serve you in your work?
Well, I think that it could better serve us in what we do by being more truth-based. As it stands now, for me, the media does not represent reality. It creates a reality, but it doesn't deal with what's really going on with our youth on a day-to-day basis. There used to be a program called Good News. I think it was on for maybe 6-8 months, and then all of a sudden it was gone because it doesn't seem like we're interested in good news, even though we say we want it and we feel it's important. When it's given to us, we don't grab onto it and make it a reality that can be seen every day. So I really think we need a revolution in the media, because as it stands now, mainstream media does not serve our needs. And until they start to do so, we're all going to be struggling to get our word and our message out and to change the perceptions that our youth are having as a result of everything that they see on the media, particularly as it relates to bling bling and you got to have this to be this and so forth and so on. And the steps that they take sometimes to get these things causes them more grief in the long run than anything.
Thank you very much, Berlina. And last but not least, we have Elisa Gong of the Woman. That's not last but not least. We've got two more panelists. I'm sorry. Elisa Gong of the Woman of Color Resource Center. Tell us a bit about how we could be more accountable, considering that Women's History Month isn't far away.
Right. Personally, definitely agree with what Berlina said, that the media so often doesn't represent truth or reality or our communities. I think for my own work at the Resource Center, I've seen that just in particular to the subject of militarism, how hard it is to find information on women of color. We'll find information on people of color, and we'll find information on women, but it's so hard to find any good information out there that injects a race and gender analysis. I think that would be a great way that if media can be encouraged more to always consider that it's not just a race or it's not just a gender issue, but race and gender together, there's so many complexities there. And also I think it would be great if the media could encourage more young women of color to write and to be publishing more women of color writers. We need to hear those stories, and we really need to hear those perspectives in us for us to understand what that real truth is, that reality that isn't being portrayed by present media.
Thank you very much. And we'll go to Celine Schein with the same question of how the media can serve your organization.
Yes, I think with the media, one thing that I would really love to see is more of a look at the complexity of cultures. Oftentimes, there's this dichotomy presented of there's Western dance, music, what have you, and then the rest of the world, world music, world dance, and there's so much more complexity than that. If you were to just look at India, there are at least 7 to 8, depending on who you talk to, classical forms and hundreds of folk forms. And so it's really important that when looking at the arts, that one looks at it with really an understanding that it's as complex as our world. It's not one and then the other. It's not just the West and then the rest of the world. So that's something that the media could really help with.
Okay, thank you very much.
It's been great to have all of the panelists here in studio for another, yet another Full Circle Community Open House. And normally we would take time right now to give out your information, but we're going to post it up on our website. We're inside our fun drive, and it's time for us to have our listeners give back to us, and we appreciate all that you give back to our community. So thank you all for being here.
We've been your hosts, William and Idris, and after a music break, we'll be right back with you. Stay tuned.
Ooh, thanks, studio audience. That's hot. Awesome.
Starvation is a creation of the devil, a rebel. I'm bringing food to the people like a widow, bringing flowers to a grave in the middle of the city. Isolation is a riddle, to be surrounded by a million other people, but feel alone like a tree in the desert, dried up like the skin of a lizard, but full of color like the spots of a leopard. Drum and bass pull me in like a shepherd, scratch my itch like a needle on the wreck. Full of life like a man going to Mecca. Sky high like an eagle up soaring. I speak low but I'm like a lion roaring. Baritone like a Robeson recording. I'm giving thanks for being human every morning. Morning, morning. Because the streets are alive with the sound of boom bap. Can I hear it once again? Boom bap. Tell your neighbor, tell a friend. Every flower got a right to be blooming. The streets are alive with the sound of boom bop. Can I hear it once again? Boom bop. But tell your neighbor, tell a friend. Every flower got a right to be blooming. Be resistant the negativity, we keep it at a distance. Call for backup and I'll give you some assistance. Like a lifesaver deep in the ocean. Stay afloat here upon the funky motion. Rock and roll upon the waves of the season. Hold your breath and you're underwater breathing. To be rhyming without a real reason is to claim but not to practice a religion. If television is the drug of the nation, satellite is immaculate reception. Beaming in, they can look and they can listen. So you see, don't believe in the system to legalize you or give you your freedom. You want rights, ask them to read them. But every flower got a right to be blooming. Stay human, because the streets are alive with the sound of boom bap. Can I hear it once again? Boom bap. But tell your neighbor, tell a friend. Every flower got a right to be blooming. The streets are alive with the sound of boom bap. But can I hear it once again? Boom bap. But tell your neighbor, tell a friend. Every flower got a right to be blooming. Because all the freaky people make the beauty of the world. All the freaky people make the beauty of the world. All the freaky people make the beauty of the world. All the freaky people make the beauty of the world. Because all the freaky people make the beauty of the world. Aha. We saw the freaky people make the beauty of the world. Stay human. See why 2K and 2 is a moment in time we find that we can open up a heart that's locked or been broken by the pain of words not spoken, nor shot by guns are still smoking. Cartwrights out on the Ponderosa, or drive by banging Testarossa. We need to heed the words of Dalai Lama, or at least the words of your mama. Take a mental trip to the Bahamas. Steam your body in the stereo sauna, sauna.
This is Josh Elwood, and you're listening to Full Circle on KPFA FM 94.1. Please support us with your pledge.
Out there for any men that are looking for a wonderful opportunity.
Right on, Josh. Right on.
Yes, that was our own Josh Elwood, who helped with the technical setup for this event tonight, preceded by music by Michael Franti, the song Stay Human from the CD Eye of the Storm.
048.
A CD that offers 21 tracks, including spoken word and music by...
Spoken word and tracks by the...
Bay Area's up-and-coming best emerged and celebrated artists. The CD also features stories by survivors of Hurricane Katrina. You are listening to KPFA 94.1. This is Full Circle, and we are on our fun drive. We are your hosts, William and Janine, as well as Antonio.
Yes, I am here.
Greetings.
Yes, and if you call in at 1-800-HEY-KPFA, that is 1-800-439-5732, and make your $60 donation.
You will be able to get the CD that just ended. It was there. But, you know, it's beautiful here during Fun Jive. It is just so beautiful. You just got the fervor. We've got a live studio audience, and we've got the beautiful sounds in the background. And we've got you, the listeners, and we hope that you're calling right now to support us, because we really are here as a graduate apprentices, all of us here on the mic. Right. And, oh, right.
That's right.
There is something on, dear. We're here. We're on. We're on. So,
and the key word that we're focusing on tonight is community. We just had a bunch of community organizations come in and speak to us about what it is that they do, how it is that they participate and help the community. And we're here, KPFA and Full Circle, also as media participants in a nonprofit organization, helping our community as well. Eye of the Storm was produced by the Ella Baker Center and blessed with the talents of artists in the Bay Area community. It was made to support grassroots rebuilding efforts for Katrina survivor. Our community is helping their community, so you, our listeners, can score a triple play with your pledge. You'll be supporting the apprenticeship program, which is an affirmative action program teaching women and people of color radio skills. You'll be supporting listener-sponsored KPFA, the first listener-sponsored radio station in the nation, and Hurricane Katrina survivors. So all the proceeds of the CD sales go to community rebuilding efforts. So this is a triple play. Please call 1-800-439-5732. That's 1-800-439-5732, or you can call locally 510-848-5732.
Yes, yes. We, too, as communities of color, need support. We need supplies. We need equipment. Things break down, as we just heard sometimes. We need your support to keep going here at KPFA.
Much love.
1-800-439-5732, 510-848-5732. If you're calling right down the street in Berkeley or in Oakland, if you're calling outside the area, again, it's 1-800-HEY-KPFA, 1-800-439-5732. In order to restore New Orleans, and I actually had the opportunity to go down to New Orleans in November, and there's still a lot of restoration that needs to happen down there. And the premium that we're offering this evening, it includes what's rich in the art and music of that area. It's African, it's French, it's Spanish roots. The underserved people there need support of communities across the U.S. And the CD that we're hearing represents the support of Bay Area artists. The Ella Baker Center lovingly put together this CD and have allowed us to provide it as a thank you gift. So let's work together right now by calling 1-800-439-5732. I see one caller on the line. 1-800-439-KPFA, 510-848-5732.
And I would just like to talk about how important it is to get community involvement and community organizations. The apprenticeship program is an awesome, awesome program. We also have application deadlines coming up for the apprenticeship program. I think it's February 10th. We train women and people of color in radio skills, and it definitely helps our community and our media become more accountable, more accessible, and tells everyone's story. So along with getting our community organizations here, the apprenticeship program represents the community and its diversity and gets all of our stories heard. And we are your stories. We are you. You are us. And we're here to represent you. So if you want more of your representation on the air, please call us now and support the apprenticeship program, KPFA, so you can hear your voice on the radio. And it's just not heard anywhere else.
It's so true. I mean, the community organizations that you heard tonight, it's an open house that we hold at least twice annually, and we'd like you to support the station, because that's why we're here. We're a community outlet. We want organizations to become more a part of the station, because we are being accountable to our communities here. So 1-800-439-5732, 510-848-5732.
And making a donation right now is not only supporting the KPFA, but it's also supporting the the apprenticeship program.
Who?
The apprenticeship program, which is an avenue for people of color, people underrepresented people, women, and anyone who just doesn't have access to the mainstream media to get on the air, to get skills, to get their voices heard, to produce content that they find that is very important to them, that will speak to the general public. And so supporting right now is also going to support the apprenticeship program. So call 1-800-HEY-KPFA, 439-5732.
Tell your story. Get your voice heard. 1-800-439-5732 or 510-848-5732. Coming up next, we're going to listen to some more spoken word from the CD Eye of the Storm so you can get more of a taste of what that's all about.
Bless. Let's take a listen.
A tree to me used to be just a tree, a size the giant redwoods and old fat Mr. Oak Tree. The name of most trees are unknown to me. And the little bitty birds, shucks, they're just birds moving faster than squirrels. The little kitties chase but never caught in Oakland's Diamond Park where I walk. Been stepping side sunset breast robins with no identifying problems, and occasionally see a blue jay in that old twisted blank tree by the pool. But the tiny yellow-bellied bluebirds, they're strangers to me. And there is a rock-bottom creek running alongside the edge of this tree popular park where I walk. Reckon it's got a name too, probably given by an old un-American Indian when the earth and wind meant something. God bless these trees, the birds and the breeze. I prayed as I started my run towards good health. Midway through my exercise program, I passed a sand-looking ruddy red-skinned man who was hugging old fat Mr. Oak Tree. When I got done with my run, I thought about what he'd done and what I was being asked to do. In my pocket was a chalk white marble and the people's invitation.
1-800-439-5732, 510-848-5732. You've just listened to Mac Dennis, and the name of the poem is Poet for Global Justice from the CD Eye of the Storm. Our thank you gift tonight, our thank you gift to you. If you want more information about this CD, check out the website. It's ellabakercenter.org. But I want you to check out another website right now. It's the KPFA website, and you can log on there. You can donate at any level. I mean, right now, this what we're offering is $60, but times are hard, and you know, if times are hard for you, you can donate. I mean, sometimes times are easy, and if you got $600, $6,000, $6 million, we take it all. I mean, any donation that you can make, $6, whatever you can do. 510-848-5732.
Whatever you can do, that's a good point. And you also can break your payments up so you don't have to pay it all at once.
That's
right. You can pay them in installments. We like to work with you. So once again, the number is 1-800-439-5732 or 510-848-5732. The CD Eye of the Storm features 20 original works by slam winning poets, gospel and soul artists, nationally renowned musicians. But we are offering this as a love offering. What you get weekly also is a love offering from apprentices who spend a lot of time here at the radio station to get skills and a lot of time to bring the show to you every week. This is from 7 to 8 p.m. and we are here around the clock. This is a love. This is passion for us. So radio is who we are and what we do, and we like to bring it to you and make sure that we're doing it well.
That's right. 7 to 8 is Full Circle.
Yes.
Every week. And also, if you listen throughout the day, if you hear the community calendar, that is also produced by the apprentices, where they inform the public about upcoming events. They do the mixing of the music, and that's another way for them to get skills and also to promote events that is done by the community.
Community events that are announced every hour and public service announcements, those are also produced by the apprenticeship program, and a number of the shows that you hear here at the station are often engineered by apprentices throughout the day, throughout the night, from the morning show where we have a lot of apprentices that Kirsten Thomas, who's the engineer for the morning show, is a graduate apprentice, as well as a number of the folks she's trained to help keep that show running when she's not able to be there.
We all are.
I think everyone on this mic has done the morning show here. So
yeah.
We're here working. The apprenticeship program trained over 300 people that have come through the station that are offering their skills here as graduates. They're offering their skills in the media world out at KQED, out at NPR.
That's
we're
right.
all over the place. And it's about giving back. We as apprentices gave many hours and continue to give many hours as well as the folks who produce this show that you're listening to right now.
Mm-hmm.
So we are asking you, the listeners, to give back right now. And by calling 510-848-5732, join that one caller on the phone right now, because there was a point where there was a flurry. We'd like to see that flurry continue. In the 5 minutes that we're standing here, we'd like to see 5 lights light up. And hopefully you take the premium home, Eye of the Storm, for a $60 pledge, which breaks down to $5 a month for the year. 5 people on the phones right now, 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732.
Right, and the CD that we're offering includes music by Michael Franti, Poet Laureate, Devereaux Major, Aya De Leon, Shelja Patel, Michael McFadden, Alphabet Soup, who got together back together for this project, Mike Molina, Vukani Mawetu, The Freedom Choir, Aglides Church, Vernon Bush, Renee Wilson from the movie Ray, Youth Speaks Poets, and Soulography, and many, many more.
And Eric McFadden. We don't want to... Michael McFadden's great, but Eric McFadden's who
Eric
you're going to find
McFadden.
On this CD. 510-848. Because there's some Michael McFadden fans. 510-848-5732. We don't want to scare you. 1-800-439-5732 if you'd like that premium.
And remember, it's $60, but you can give more. We welcome anything upwards up to $1 million if you're willing to give $1 million.
Hey,
you can do it.
Do it.
Affirmative action. This is bringing balance to the media airwaves, and the apprenticeship program does that, and it's very needed in this time and space.
Folks who've been a part of the apprenticeship program have gone on to produce a number of different specials here, from Martin Luther King Day to Gay Pride to La Raza, La Raza History Month. It's Cinco de Mayo, a number of different specials that we've done here at the station. And a lot of the specials, in addition to specials, we do a lot of different pieces for Radio Chronicles, for a number of different shows. And it's bringing stories to the air that you normally wouldn't hear from communities that historically haven't gotten a space here at Pacifica. So that's why we're here at Full Circle. That's why we're here at the apprenticeship program. And that's why we need you to be that fourth caller on the phone. 510-848-5732. 1-800-439-5732, because time's running out.
Or you can call 1-800-HEY-KPFA, which is 439-5732, if that's easier for you to remember. That is HEY-KPFA.
Hey.
And remember that also Music of the World, most of those producers are former apprentices, and they bring you music that you would not hear otherwise, that you wouldn't hear on corporate media.
Definitely. And that website also is kpfa.org. I believe that you can also pledge on the website.
24 hours a day. 7 days a week.
So
don't
we
sleep.
Are here. Also, it'd be good if people could pledge also now,
mm-hmm.
7 to 8 p.m. for Full Circle, produced by the apprenticeship program. Once again,
439-5732. Or
510-848-5732.
And
KPFA?
Yeah.
.org. This is also KPFB in Berkeley or KFCF in Fresno. This reaches, I believe, one third of the state.
Yeah, Santa Rosa to Santa Cruz, all the way to Fresno.
From Sacramento to San Jose.
1-800-439-5732 for folks in Sacramento and San Jose. 510-848-5732.
Well, that brings us to the end of tonight's show. Tune in next week to Full Circle at the same time, Friday from at 7 to 8 p.m., same station, KPFA 94.1 FM. You also can check out our archived shows at www.kpfa.org.
Special thanks to our production interns, Dara, Idris, Felicia, and Tai. And to our technical interns, Sema, Grace, Mia, Lavinia, and Leali. And thanks also to Antonio Ortiz.
Our segment editor is none other than my co-host is here, Janine Etter.
Queen Janine.
You go. Our senior producer is Veronica Moscoso. Our technical director is Miss M. Advisors are Rangita Giesler and Amelia Gonzalez. If you have further questions or topics for future shows, write us at 1929 Martin Luther King Jr. Way in Berkeley, California, 94704. If you want to purchase a taped copy of our show, our email is fullcircle@kpfa.org, and our telephone number is area code 510-848-6767, extension 627.
With Leali at the controls, we've been your hosts, William, together with myself, Queen Janine, and Idris Hassan, and Antonio Ortiz, at the community open.